I can't wait to melt you, Frosty. I really hate you so much, Frosty. But time to burn you and your hat. Oh. Hi. I'm 3200 Music Surfer, and I hope you didn't see so much where I was gonna burn down Frosty the Snowman and set his hat on fire. Wait, what did I say? Nothing. I didn't say anything about Frosty and hit me hating him so much. Blah, blah. Nope. Whatever. Anyway, what was I going to review next? I can't read backwards. Does that say? Oh, I see now. I'm gonna review. Oh God. A Christmas Carol. Yeah, I know there's been 500 different kinds of releases of that movie, but why should I really care? Let's see. This is the one where I gotta go more currently. This is the one with Jim Carrey. Now, Jim Carrey, as you know, is a very funny man who. Wait, give me a second. Who, yes, did a lot of the voices, kind of like Eddie Murphy-esque, voice. In voice acting and playing more than one character, but I digress. Anyway, in this movie, it's kind of like all the others, I mean, it's kind of like all the other movies that were, I mean, all the other Christmas Carol movies. They're nothing that spectacular except for it being, an animated movie, with all CG and stuff. But this kind of does it a little different. They make Jim Carrey out into a very old guy. Scrooge actually looks a lot like Jim Carrey, if you know what I mean, except he's really old and wrinkled and all that. He's usually just that same Scrooge, kind of like the Grinch, but I digress. Anyway, I'm saying I'm saying. Oh yeah, first of all, it's Christmas, I mean Christmas Eve, and then same stuff. If you've seen the movie, one movie, you'd see it all. But this one's kind of unique in a way. How can I explain it? Well, simply this. First of all, just kind of it's very good. I mean, the story, same, not, nothing new. But the imagery was very, very good. First of all, there's Christmas Past, who's actually changed from different kinds of people. There was this little girl or this little kid, and then there was a spirit, then there was a snowflake, I think. And then there was, God. And then there was, this one is now a candle. Christmas Past, kind of awkward and really different from everyone else, but still, it's pretty cool though. And then next is Christmas Present, who in every movie is like a jolly fat man, kind of like Santa Claus, but not really. But he's always been my kind of favorite Christmas version. I don't know why. I guess it was just so cheery and everything was so colorful and pretty. And then it gets to a scene where, Christmas Present, if you've seen the movie, it's kind of, ooh, just, I mean, it gets to a point where it's kind of eerie, and, it's, I mean, the jolly fat man, this guy laughing and everything, it was just so cool, and then the whole room moved and everything, it was just a fantastic scene, until he gets older. I mean, that's him. He's still laughing. He gets older and older and older and older, really fast and really drastic. And it gets even scarier. It's like he turns into a fucking skeleton. And he's still laughing and laughing, and then turns to ash, and then there's the glass and everything. Jesus, that was just fucking eerie. Oh. Oh, that just fucking gave me a nightmare, because since, you know, Christmas Present has always been my favorite, and then they turn them into like that. That's just creepy. Anyway, then it gets to Christmas Past, I mean, sorry, Christmas Future, or Christmas Things to Come. And then there's just, yeah, same Grim Reaper-esque looking guy, but anyway, nothing that special, and, you know, just nothing that, I mean, extreme. I have a lot on my mind right now. Okay, fine. I can tell you what I'm gonna be doing. Yeah, it gets to a point where everyone starts to hate Frosty the Snowman. First of all, I don't know what they've been putting in his corncob pipe. But when it gets to his corncob pie, I think somebody's been putting a little bit too much of the, too many mistletoes in his corncob pie, if you know what I mean. And so, I guess I want revenge. That damn snowman keeps saying happy birthday and always trying to be cheery. Oh well. I guess, whatever. I just really want revenge on Frosty so much. Because, you know, it gets to a point sometimes where you're a teenager and then you start to get pissed at Frosty because of all his same stupid specials. So, I guess, anyway, I'm going to say thank you and good night. Wait a minute. There is a drug relationship between all the Christmas characters. Well, first of all, Rudolph's got his red nose from snorting. Frosty's been smoking weed and always saying happy birthday or doing crack. And Santa has had the munchies. He's probably been so high lately. Let's see, what else? What else? Yeah, that's it. Anyway, thank you. Good night. I'm gonna burn down Frosty. And get ready for my homemade. Let me make my homemade blowtorch. Quick lesson, if you ever want to make a blowtorch, don't do this at home so often. First of all, start spraying anything that, you know, has a continuous spray, like Excellence, still continuously sprays, you don't have to keep pushing the button, or hairspray, or whatever. Light, and then, yeah, and it does that. Anyway, if you want to burn down Frosty, visit me, and if you want to burn down Frosty, just like me, it's a good thing.